Do you want to do wood for the living room?
Yeah, but like it was really light, like white wood.
So it's $1.49 per square foot, so.
Our kids know that our teachers and our staff members believe in them, and they internalize that belief in themselves, and they have that desire to further their own learning every day.
Okay. All right. Nice job. Keep going. I like it.
We are a Title I school here at Whiting Lane. We are also an intensive academic school. We focus a lot on growth, on student growth. Perseverance is a huge part of that. Our staff members really know I need to instill this perseverance. I need the kids to want to learn, to want to excel, to want to keep growing and keep mastering those grade level concepts.
I tried to do like 34 plus 34 is 68 and then subtract 48 to see if we could just use one level for each.
We have a very rich curriculum here in West Hartford. The learning tasks that we're asking kids to do are very rigorous.
We are going to jump into our dream house task. You are in different places, and that's okay. I'll be walking around and checking in with groups.
Today's project was a dream house task. It was a real life application of a lot of the skills that they've learned so far in math this year. Do computations with decimals, whole numbers, add, subtract, multiply, and divide. So that kind of has them practicing those skills in a real life way that they might use someday in their life.
How many different rooms do we have?
They had to create a floor plan, more than 925 square feet. And they had to make sure that all of the room dimensions met their outside dimensions.
The perimeter is 110 feet.
They have to include the flooring for all the rooms. The wallpaper and paint, that was optional. So if they got to that point, if they wanted to and they were still under budget, less than $200,000, they could then go and do the shopping to do the walls.
Times two
equals?
No way.
$143.06.
No way, we're not doing that.
Get the lighter one.
There's one group that has a ball pit and they are like waiting to purchase the balls to fill the ball pit in their house.
We're like practicing math facts, but in a really fun way by making a house. And it's like some people just don't want to keep doing normal math problems on a sheet. So we make it fun by working on a big project.
So it's 80 times two. How much is a cover?
20 square feet per case.
They love it. And it challenges them and gets them applying their math concepts in different ways.
5 by 6? For both of them? No, for the first back room.
Our teachers are selecting projects for students to work through as opposed to simply handing out a worksheet. But it's really that rich, very meaty type of project that has many steps to it that students really need to think through and struggle through in a good way. Which assists in their levels of perseverance and their stamina and their effort, which just supports all of the learning process in the end.
Their level of math has really elevated through this project.
Okay, so 12 square units for here, right?
I have students who came into fifth grade at a kindergarten level of math. I also have students that are testing for seventh grade honors. It's one of the bigger ranges that I've had in a while. So this task was challenging for all of them.
And then make sure we have the same measurements.
I like how everybody's got a different job and you're helping your group move forward.
The way that they worked together and collaborated made each individual feel like they were part of the project. And they all took ownership in the group's work. And they all brought their own strengths to it. So that kept them engaged.
It's about kids having confidence in themselves and believing in themselves. And that's a huge part of learning. It's a huge part of life for our kids later down the road.
Then you go on to paint, right?
Yeah.
So that's what we're focused on, yes?
Yeah.
Beautiful. So that's the site I should see you on.